trail. So some years he's happy and letting go of him, he's getting to stretch out. So this is still the trail walk, but it looks totally different. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. But it looks more like I'm riding a camel because he's moving back and forth like this. And that's what they say with a lot of the big gated horses is they have this camel walk. And there's ones much worse than him. So also when you try them, you want to see what they feel like in all those different speeds. So we're at a trail walk and I'm going to speed him up. Here's our flat walk. Now you see, I got a lot of motion. I look like I'm having a convulsion up here, and so you better call 911. Yeah, this horse is smooth. This is great. But you see, he's got such a big step, and now that I'm not collecting him, I'm kind of moving all over the place. And again, if I'm riding with a bunch of people, he's most likely going to get out of control and get really fast and try to pass the other ones because he's pretty competitive. All right, so this is our flat walk. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm really not, like, jerking my body. This is just him with the motion going through me. All right, so let's go our running walk. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you'll see I'm kind of bouncing up down a little bit because this horse that's pretty nicely gated is getting a little bit pacey with me out here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So again, you might feel like this is a nicer thing to do on the trail, but it's really not. It's uncomfortable for me, it's uncomfortable for him because I'm bouncing all over his back. And he's not going to use himself, and since I want to ride for a long period of time, I want him to be able to save that energy and do the gait correctly. So again, if he's doing the running walk and I just shorten up, bring him up, you can see what a big difference that is, right? So he slows way out. Now again, when you're doing the gates, you got to start with that flat walk and get it and get that horse to frame himself up in order to help him to gate.